something. Driving me crazy. Put down that phone, both hands on your steering wheel. Hang up and drive, driving me crazy. Hey, that ain't no phone booth, son, it's your automobile.
Hi, vloggers!
Hi, vloggers!
We are listening to a little bit of Ray Stevens' Hang Up and Drive.
We're driving back from Miami today on July 14th, 2007, and we are talking about how annoying all the people are with cell phones.
So many people on their phones while driving, and it's not so much if you can drive and pay attention, it's just those people that don't pay attention when they're on their phones.
And how are you guys?
How's it going?
We missed you.
So, we had a great day today.
We did. Do you want to tell them a little bit about it?
Well, we got to go to the Miami Metro Zoo and see Go Diego Go.
Actually, Diego's Discovery Den.
Diego's Discovery Den. That's right.
Yeah. It was really fun. This was a whirlwind week, but we did three shows today, and the show is a combination of a little song and dance about animal rescuing. And in the middle of it, we meet three different animals. Rudy, the red-footed tortoise, is one. Then we meet Jorge, the guinea pig. And then we meet Sam, the boa constrictor. And we met some really nice people who we think might be tuning into the vlog as well.
I know, I'm very excited. Yeah. I want to hear from them too.
I'm just going to mention all their names because I just thought they were great. There was Adriel, there was Damon, there was Joe, there was Melissa.
Barbara.
Christina. Lauren.
Stephanie,
who was the heads up this production company, and she was terrific. And her husband, Mark. Looks a little bit like Mark Anthony.
And Scott. Ben.
And Ben. Ben was our audio guy and did a great job. But they were really nice
very
people,
nice.
And we had such a good time. On top of it, talk a little bit about some of the zoo people that we met.
Oh, right. We met Paul from the zoo.
Yeah.
He was the guy who kind of...
The marketing guy
who got this all together and made it happen.
And he was so proud of it.
He was. And there was Adam, who is the, I guess, the children's zookeeper.
Yeah.
Area's manager or whatever, area guy for the children's zoo park. And who else was there?
There were many. And the thing is...
So many of them.
We got to see things that I just never would have imagined because they were really happy to share with us. Like, we watched them feed the meerkats one day.
Right.
Which was fascinating. And they were interested in sharing all kinds of information and kind of inspired us a little bit about how wonderful it is that these zoos exist and that there are these naturalists out there that are really looking out to preserve our environment and to be worried about the introduction of species that don't belong in this environment, etc.
And that lady with the bird.
Yeah, she was nice. I don't know her name.
Oh, she was talking about the frogs and how...
Yeah, they evidently brought this species of frog into southern Florida to get rid of certain bugs, but it ended up eating a lot of the other frogs and toads, which are also important to the ecosystem. So, yeah, it was interesting. In any event, the show, the theater was this tiny little amphitheater that holds about 100. At one point, we had close to 200 people in there. It was really... It was a zoo.
And they were all excited and...
They were singing and dancing and clapping.
They were being
clapping.
Birds, caw, caw, and being monkeys, oh, ah, 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 ah.
They were. It was one of those projects that I felt really proud of being a part of. I'm really happy to know that thing will play every day and hopefully inspire young kids to become interested in the whole world of zoology.
And we learned about today at the end about we saw renderings of what Amazon and beyond the area is going to look like coming in 2008 to the Miami Metro Zoo.
And then we'll talk about some of the other animals that we saw today.
Oh my gosh, what did we see? I'm going to put some pictures up soon. I've got to do a little movie with them first, but
most notable I think was the silverback gorilla.
So beautiful.
The chimpanzees were nice. We never saw the orangutan.
And we didn't see giraffes.
No. We saw camels.
Yeah, we saw camels. We saw lions. We saw... Oh, it's getting up to 5 minutes. Get ready. Here we go. What else did we see?
It's hard for me to smile and freeze while I'm driving.
Okay, 7, 8, 9. Yeah. We also saw gorillas and chimpanzees.
It was fun.
It was great fun.
And it was fun being in Miami. It was a nice break.
It was very different pace there.
Very different pace. And boy, was it hot, wasn't
it? Oh my gosh. I wasn't used to that type of humidity.
I think I also got over some of my fear of snakes, too. I didn't really want to get chummy-chummy with them, but I'm a little less afraid. Oh, tell what happened yesterday when we went to record audio.
Oh, well, we needed to change the opening announcement and the closing announcement to say a couple of different things, like don't go up on the stage, and so we were talking with, I was going to go out and get a microphone and record it on my laptop and get everything, but the guy that was there, Mark, was helping, and he said, you know, no, I think I've got it if we do this and put this through here and, you know, all that audio talk, which I won't bore you with, and so he said, oh, let's go into the reptile room and record. And I guess they thought it was me at first that was recording the audio. And I was like, no, we need to get Bob. He's the one that's doing it. So we went and got Bob, and we just kind of walked out to this room, and he didn't really know it was going to be the reptile room.
We were surrounded with snakes and blue-tongued skinks. And,
all sorts of reptiles.
All sorts of snakes and reptiles.
Although turtles were in there, but they weren't scared.
So we had to sit on the floor surrounded. All I kept thinking of was Harrison Ford in Indiana Jones. Snakes. Did it have to be snakes?
Why did it have to be snakes?
Why did it have to be snakes?
There you go.
I'm no Harrison Ford.
Well, I'm no... Who is the girl in the movie? I can't even remember her name.
It ended up Spielberg's wife.
Oh, right. The first one.
Yeah,
first one. So,
what else? People sent, I think Ryan let us know what the Fear of Friday the 13th is, but we don't have it available, so I can't even attempt to pronounce it.
Yeah, we're offline. Sorry.
He gave us it phonetically.
Again, well, we're going to touch on everything that everyone has commented on, and I've got to get a new poll out there, and I would give you the poll numbers, but I don't have any of that information.
You know,
so we'll deal with that tomorrow when we get back home.
Doris had mentioned the audiobooks of Harry Potter and how good they were because she said that the author was so good. It's the author's Jim Dale, who originated the role of Barnum on Broadway with Glenn Close.
Kevin Miller was telling us about that.
And Kevin Miller wrote in. I just like how people add things. Doris mentioned it, and then Kevin added how good he is. And we're going to get them. I'm going to have to listen to them.
Yeah.
There was interesting information online about those books on tape.
Yeah, Jim's website and different things.
Yeah. Yeah, what else has been commenting? There was other people that have commented on things.
There's all sorts of things. Mike was commenting on Hairspray, and I don't remember what all that was. Oh my god, we're already to 8 minutes.
Yeah, Mike was telling us about... Well, he was talking about that there are actually other straight performers who have played it, like Michael McKean, who replaced Harvey Fierstein as...
But who originated it? A gay man...
Well, yeah, it's interesting. And he also reminded us that the fellow who is playing...
Link?
Yeah, he would have been too old for... No.
Oh, the guy who's playing Corny.
Yeah.
Corny Collins.
He's too old for the other part.
And that's true.
That is true.
Because... And I'm not saying that Zach's bad, because Zach is probably going to be wonderful. I love his rendition of the song and everything, so I don't mean to put him down, but...
We're 8 miles from a Starbucks, and I'm thinking of stopping. Yeah, maybe we'll find the Wi-Fi there, and we could actually upload this so you guys get it. It's about 6:20 in the afternoon. We left the park around 4, so we don't expect to be home till about 9 or so tonight.
Wild.
Yeah.
But, So
that's it, I guess. Where are we at time-wise?
9:20. We got a few more minutes to fill.
Mm-hmm.
So,
we're going to be back in Orlando for the next couple of weeks, which will feel good. And I hope we hear from some of the folks at the zoo. I'd like to hear from
them. That would be fun.
Yeah.
Add another little link in our World Wide Web.
Yes, exactly.
So, all right, vloggers, have a great day, and we will talk to you tomorrow.
Yeah, maybe we can even post a little of Diego at some point.
Oh, that could be fun.
All right.
See you later, vloggers.
Bye. Have a good Saturday night. Be safe.